Today I am going to tell you some important thing about the brand new Sigma 16mm 1.4. Most likely you have heard from other people that this is a great lens to have, mostly for those people who are doing vlogging. In fact, this is not true. If you have been following YouTubers, probably those people who have Sony system, they would definitely recommend you 16mm 1.4 because this lens gives you equivalent of 24mm for a full frame camera, and it gives you a very beautiful shallow depth of field. This is not for full frame camera, which you already know. So I'm going to give you some reasons that you should not go for this lens, and the reason is it's not that I have read all those reviews and I have seen YouTubers talking about it. I have experienced it in some of my projects, like I shoot weddings, so I have seen some problem with this lens. The first reason for which you should not go for this lens is that if you're a vlogger and if you love doing vloggings, then this lens, if you pair it with 6000 and 6300, then this lens is going to give you short shaky photos because it doesn't have image stabilization. Now the second thing, this lens is too sharp to make a cinematic video, because for photos this lens is outstanding. The quality of image which you are going to get with this lens at this price it's really commendable. But this lens is good for photography, but if you are doing videography, then since it doesn't have image stabilization, it gives you a little bit shaky because it doesn't look professional at all. So you have to come into your system and do all the post-processing afterwards. So in photography and cinematography, you want to have some devices, or maybe you must have known that I'm talking about cameras, which makes your work easier. So keeping that thing in mind, I would want to recommend this lens to anyone who have 16-50 already in their camera. So most probably if you have a camera like this one is 6000, and 6000 comes with this one, 16-50. So 16-50 is a good lens if you are doing photography, videography, you can do vloggings with it, there will be no issue with it. But you won't get that shallow depth of field which you really want to make your video look cinematic. So that's the one thing. So this lens comes with Sony camera free of cost, and if you go ahead and buy that Sigma lens, it's costly. It will cost you somewhere around $500 US. So it's a good investment if you do a landscape photoshoot, because that lens is very sharp, and if you go ahead and if you go out and shoot some landscape, you will definitely see the difference. But apart from that, if you buy this 16mm, then you will have one more benefit with it. If you are shooting just like me, because I'm shooting in my home studio, and if you have low light, it can work in a low light scenario. So the lens is 1.4, so it can work in low light scenario. But if you're going out in a daylight, and if you think that you are gonna shoot with this lens at 1.4, then you will need an ND filter. Without that, your footage is gonna look like crap. Now, if you have 16 to 50mm, this one, if you have it and you want to do vlogging, then this one lens is very good because it has IS, it has body image stabilization. If you do handheld movements, then this lens can help you with that. And apart from that, if you lower down the aperture to f8, f7, f6, or maybe f10, then this lens also gives you a similar result in landscape photography. So if you want to have a lens for vlogging, then I will recommend you to go with 16-50 instead of going for 16mm prime lens is good for photography, but it's also good for videography if you are using 6500 or 6600, and if you don't have and you still have a gimbal to stabilize your footage, then this lens is always a good purchase. But if you don't have those things and you want to spend in a one body and 16mm 1.4, then you definitely gonna regret it, because the video will come out shaky, and at the end of the day you would definitely find it's not appealing to you at all. So my recommendation is that if you have money, go for it, buy a stabilizer. And if you don't have a body right now, then if you buy this lens, then you'll have to buy a body which is already sensor stabilized. So you can go for 16-6500 or maybe 6600. And if you already have a body like maybe 6000-6300, then if you buy this lens, then you would definitely need a stabilizer for videos. And for photos, this lens is very recommended. You can buy this lens for photo because the quality of the photo that you're gonna get with this lens is definitely worth buy. So if you like my channel, definitely go ahead and subscribe it, and if you have any question, you can write down in the comment section. I will definitely love to answer your questions. And if you have anything that you want to know about Sony cameras or lenses, ask me in the comment section. So thanks for watching and have a good day.